Hey guys, what's happening? So here I am working on the Journey side art, and I want to show you where we are with this. This has been a fun project for sure, and I want to show you the difference of what we were working with originally to where I'm going with it now. So check it out. Alright guys, so this is the original scanned in. You can see the colors. Everything looks a little overly saturated and blue, and see the lines on the sides. It's just modelly looking and it's not very appealing. So here is my version. Now you can see the difference in the colors. You now have purple. Now like I said, I took this from an actual album, the original album. And you can see there's an enormous difference in the quality and also my halo around the outside. Now, if you notice over there, those lines, the letters don't line up because the original album, the lettering journey went straight. So I had to go in and take all those points out actually on both sides because those angles will change from each shot, you know, one side to the other. So that's what I've been working on, and it's been taking a lot of work, but it really does pay off. You can see how it covers it up. So here we are at the printing stage. So colors came out pretty good. I'm very happy with the end results, and it is now time to let this thing dry for a day, laminate it, and get this bad boy on the machine where it belongs. What's up guys? Today we are going to put some side art on the journey. This is a restored journey that I did the painting. This was already not in really bad condition, but we just did some painting on the sides, some little bit of cosmetic work, and I redid the artwork out there. So we're going to apply that. I'm sure you guys have seen me put on some side art before, but I want to show you some techniques if anyone has missed it. So first thing we're going to do is I want to clean this thing with alcohol. This has been sitting in my shop for a few months now, and if there's been any contamination or anything, we're going to start out with just cleaning that with regular alcohol. You can see if there's any fingerprints or anything like that, we want to remove those. Now this surface is not painted with a roller. I did spray this. And this is a polyurethane spray, so it's very durable and it's not going to scratch very easy. So that's what's nice about this stuff. And there are a lot of things, if you notice latex, I don't know if you guys ever painted latex, it always feels sticky, like it never seems to fully dry. Alright, so this is the print. I have close to 20 hours in redoing this art. It's a combination of going off an original, and then I also took we found an actual album cover that was brand new sealed, and we scanned the actual album to get more accurate colors. So I kind of went off of both to make this happen. So first thing we're gonna do is just roughly tape this up here. And I know from the other side, because I already did that, I want 1 3/8 on the side. So what I suggest is get your center first. And then I had 2 3/8 here. But this is a longer span, so I'm going to more be concerned with this being 1 3/8 down here, which it's not. So by having just one piece of tape, you saw that thing is able to swivel and rotate without having to keep untaping the whole thing. So we have an equal 1 3/8 here. All right, so that's it. Once I have that on there, I'm just gonna put a couple more pieces here for security. And I'm only gonna work one portion at a time. So let me move these down. So I'm just gonna tear off that much. A lot of people worry about how they're gonna line it up. You know, they get concerned with that. And when it's taped like this, you really don't, you're not dealing with only a small portion at a time. This one's to be sliced. Make sure that your knife is not cutting into the surface. I like to use a 3M tack rag, and this is just to get any dust and lint off. It's already been cleaned before that. And then my squeegee I use has Velcro, the soft side, on the edge so it won't scratch the vinyl. So now we're going to start with here. And this stuff is very user friendly. It's bubble free, so it's very easy to work with. Okay, once that's on, we don't need the tape anymore because it's been put on there. Now we're going to come up here. Let me get the tack rag. I don't know if you can zoom in or not, but you can see the little bit of dust just from this being around. So that's why I want to dust this back off. I'm very particular with having things right. All right, so now we're going to pull it halfway down. And we can hold it. And then just, this is kind of relaxed. You're not fighting anything, and just let it work itself down. Little by little. And you can just keep pulling this little at a time. And just let gravity do its job. And that's it. And when you get this is already die cut for you, so you don't have to worry about doing that. And I don't have pre-mask on it because this material is heavy enough with the laminate that it's not that flexible that you have to worry about. A lot of times, transfer paper is put on there because you don't want it to stretch. But this material, you don't have to worry about that. So that's it, guys. I hope that may help somebody to do a medallion size. You could virtually do the same thing with full side art. It would just be in a much bigger scale, but you would do the one portion and then work its way down. If it was side art, I wouldn't keep it standing up like this. I would definitely lay it on its side. That way you don't have to fight gravity and the weight of that big decal. But when it's something small like this, you don't really have to be too concerned. So that's gonna do it. You wanna take a look at it. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Till next time, see you around.